And good morning to you all. Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Okay. Right, we will start today's lesson. Before that, I introduce myself. I am Mr. M.I.M. Priyad. I'm recently appointed lecturer and confirmed to the Department of Accountancy and Finance, Faculty of Management and Commerce, Southeastern University, Sri Lanka. And I have been assigned to teach the second part of public accounting and finance. As such, I thanks my sincere thanks to head of the department, Professor Dr. Jaufer, and my favorite lecturer, MCA Nasser, who is a lecturer in charge for this subject. Today we are going to discuss about a financial management and accountability framework from which we are going to discuss many things, especially on Sri Lankan accounting framework, Sri Lankan public accounting framework. I think before this session, you have studied about the general background of public finance. It's common for all countries most of the times, I hope. And from today onwards, we are our focus, especially on financial regulations, how the public accountant, government accountant works, and how the Ministry of Finance has delegated their financial control over other government departments. So that sort of things we are going to discuss today. And also, it is very important if you have and plan to sit for open competitive examination for the recruitment of accountant service, public accountant service, it may be very helpful to you. And I hope it is very helpful to prepare the open competitive examination for the recruitment of public Sri Lankan accountant service. Hope we will get the things right, and we will first we will discuss the basic basics mean. You have been studied in the previous lectures, so it is very important to understanding the financial management framework. So therefore, I have taken some slides from your previous lectures, and we will just go through and we remind the things what you have studied, and from that we will continue our session. Okay, let's go into the slides. The legal and constitution, legal framework, that is constitution, right? Constitution. So the constitution of Sri Lanka, chapter 18, right? Chapter 18 of the constitution of Domestic Social Republic of Sri Lanka, our country, article from 148 to 154, contains broad principle on public finance. So first you have to understand, you already know the what is public finance. Most of the times you have spent throughout the course on corporate finance, corporate accountant, the accountant, corporate accountant. But our focus on the government, how do we manage public fund, government fund. So our areas for mainly focus on this, right? So the chapter 18 of the constitution of Sri Lanka explains how the public finance can be managed by the officers. First, article 148, it says the full control over the public finance lies with the parliament. The parliament has ultimate responsibility to manage the public fund. And we, citizens of Sri Lanka, we elect our representatives to the parliament, and the parliament, the member of parliaments together are responsible control over the public finance. And the Article 149 says all government revenues flow into consolidated fund. So whatever the revenue collected by the government officials, authorities, it directly goes to consolidated fund. It may be in the form of income tax, VAT, and fines, penalties, whatsoever, except any special arrangement. So all funds will flow into the consolidated fund. Say, for example, COVID-19 fund. Is it belongs to consolidated fund or separate fund? So the general rule is all funds collected by the government should flow to the consolidated fund, the common fund, no? But there are some special arrangements like COVID-19 fund and the National Kidney Fund, National President Fund, and APIVENU and API Fund. So this kind of funds are not flow to the consolidated fund because it has a separate legal arrangements, right? So this understanding is very important. And the Article 150 says warrants under the hand of the Ministry of Finance is to be issued for any withdrawals from consolidated fund. Okay. All the funds will go to the consolidated fund or the public funds. And for the expenditure, for the government public expenditure, the withdrawal of fund from consolidated fund, it is in the hand of Ministry of Finance. The Ministry of Finance will issue warrants to each departments and ministries, right? So the power in the hand of Ministry of Finance. And Article 151, it says the parliament may by law create a contingencies fund for the purpose of providing for urgent and unforeseen expenditure. There are some instances government needs some funds for emergency situations like tsunami, flood, cyclone. So in that time, they want additional fund to meet unforeseen expenditures. So in that scenario, circumstances, parliament may create a contingencies fund. And 152 says no bill or motion affecting revenues shall be introduced in parliament except by a minister with the approval of the cabinet. So all the bill and motions for the expenditure and revenue, right, the revenue should be taken the approval from the cabinet, right, minister. By the Minister of Finance, they have taken an approval from the cabinet. And Article 53 says the appointment of Auditor General. Auditor General by the President, subject to the approval of the Constitutional Council. So we know the Auditor General, he is the responsible person for the all public finance management, audit of public finance management. And the appointment of Auditor General is done by President, but this appointment is subject to approval of the Constitutional Council. There's a council, the group of officers. So based on the approval of Constitutional Council, the President may appoint Auditor General. And the Article 153, subsection A to H, it says constitution of the Audit Service Commission vested with the power on the appointment, promotion, transfer, disciplinary control and dismissal of members belongs to the Sri Lanka State Audit Service, right? And the 154 says duties and function of the Auditor General and report to the Parliament within 10 months. Succeeding 10 months, the Auditor General Department should report to the Parliament. And introduction, I'm going a little fast because everything have these slides, the introductory slides, or you have done, you have studied already in the previous session. For the reminding purpose, so I have used that slides. I have taken the slides from them. And it is important for a public sector manager and officers entrusted with financial and accounting responsibilities to understand operational framework within which public financial management and accountability are implemented and achieved. Right, if you are an accountant for a company, private company, corporation, when you prepare financial statements, financial reports, all the times, you realize, you follow what? Please, anybody of you? You follow what? Anybody of you, please respond. When you prepare financial accounting, financial statements, financial reports, you follow what? Please unmute your mic and accounting standards, especially Sri Lanka Financial Reporting Framework, SLFRS, and LKS, Sri Lanka Accounting Standards, right? So based on that, accountants, financial managers prepare the financial statement. And also they have to follow any internal circulars of the company. Likewise, if you are appointed as a manager of public accountant in the public service departments, public organizations, you have to follow the financial regulation, not LKS or not IAS, not Sri Lanka financial accounting frameworks. You have to follow the financial regulations, right? You have to follow the financial regulations and the circulars, which is issued by the Ministry of Finance on behalf of the government of Sri Lanka, right? So it is important for a public sector manager. Public sector manager mean, assume that for your understanding purpose, you have been appointed as a accountant in a divisional secretariat or the department, right? Even university bursars also, they have to follow the financial regulations. It is important for a public sector manager and officer entrusted with financial and accounting responsibilities. So therefore, they should understand the operational framework. Operational framework is what? For corporate accountant, company accountant, their framework is what? LKS, LKS and SLFRS. But for the public service, they have to rely on the operational framework, that is public financial management accountability are implemented and achieved. And this includes inter alia and amat, and inter alia means, among other things, various authorities involves and their powers and responsibilities and how they delegate responsibilities to. So financial regulations of government of Sri Lanka lays regulations and guidance on this aspect. So in sum, financial regulation of government of Sri Lanka lays regulations and guidance on this aspect. So how the public accountant, government accountants would work. So this is the operational manual of the accountant, finance managers in the public sector. Right, now we move on financial regulations. Right, financial regulations. Financial regulations is issued under the hand of Ministry of Finance. Financial regulation is issued by the Ministry of Finance. So who is issuing IAS and LKS? Not IAS, LKS, SLFRS. Who is responsible in Sri Lanka? Who is issuing that? Who is issuing in Sri Lanka? Anybody of you, please respond via chat box, or you can unmute your mic. We can respond. So ICASL, there's a board called Sri Lanka Auditing and Accounting Monitoring Board in collaboration with ICASL, Sri Lanka Institute of Chartered Accountants, right? So both of them are with the collaboration, with collaborative work, they are issuing IAS, not IAS, LKS and SLFRS. Likewise, the financial regulations are issued by the Ministry of Finance. The financial regulations provide regulatory framework within which the government financial transactions are carried out. In corporate accounting, all the financial transactions and events are carried out by the LKS and SLFRS. In same way, public accountants should follow financial regulations. And the financial regulations intend to ensure ordinarily financial transactions in public sector institutions. So they have to ensure they are following financial regulation in every financial transaction. And the present FR, financial regulation, it was issued in 1992. So you can find it in the Ministry of Finance website, Treasury website. And also I have uploaded the financial regulation in your VLD, right? So you can access that PDF file. It was issued in 1992. After that, there are some amendments. So those amendments you can find in the Ministry of Finance website. So, and earlier there was a regulations frame that was issued in 1966, financial regulation. So the 1992 is a latest edition. So therefore, the latest edition supersedes the previous edition that was issued in 1966. The present FR supersedes the 1966 financial regulation. And the FR, financial regulations, are binding on ministers, departments, statutory bodies, and all state employees. They have to bind. The financial regulations control all the acts, financial transaction of ministers, ministries, departments, secretaries, bodies, right? So all government departments, financial transactions are bounded under this regulation, financial regulation. In case of government corporations, these financial regulations will apply unless they have adopted their own comprehensive financial regulations, rules and procedure. So this financial regulation is common for all government sectors, but there are some organizations, so departments, so they have developed their own financial regulations based on the common financial regulations, right? They have adapted they have adopted financial regulation issued under Ministry of Finance in 1992. So that regulation will supersede their own comprehensive financial regulation will supersede the common financial regulations. And financial regulation in general. So here, the financial regulation having this contents, right? So FR mainly deals with the regulation of the following aspects. Estimate of expenditure and revenue, authorities and expenditure, refund and write-off, financial management and accountability, receipts and payments, custody of public money, interest and bank accounts, accounting and books of accounts, advance accounts, kachari accounts, courts accounts, foreign aids, printing and publications, supplies, work services, and miscellaneous. So these are the content of financial regulations. But our focus on this chapter is financial management accountability, right? Financial management and accountability is one of the chapter, one of the section in the financial regulation, right? Financial regulation deals with many things listed here. But our focus here is this. Financial management accountability is one of the chapter in the financial regulations. For your reference, I have already uploaded in VLE, the financial regulations, right? You can just go through that at least. Here, the financial management and accountability, so it has been, it is late in the financial regulation number, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 131. So these financial regulations numbers, right? So we are saying, you know, LKS, according to LKS 2, we are dealing in inventories. LKS 16, they are dealing with property, plant, equipment. LKS 12, are dealing with income tax. So likewise, the financial regulation deal with financial management accountability in the in this number, financial regulation numbers, right? So to refer, so how, say for example, here in corporate accounting, right? Corporate accounting. So what is assets? What is liability? What is expenditure? What is income? So that sort of things are explained where? Sri Lanka financial reporting framework. Likewise, the government financial management framework, financial management and accountability is laid in the financial regulation FR 124, 25, 26, 27, 28, and 131. Please go there and please refer it. Here, the financial management and accountability, the chapter, right? We start from financial regulation 121, 24, right? It is very important if you have an idea to sit open competitive examination for Sri Lanka accounting service, accountant service, right? If you want to become an accountant in government sector, you should know the financial regulation. One paper on this section, right? FR 124, the Ministry of Finance has laid down the broad framework within which departmental financial transaction of all kinds may be undertaken, right? All the financial transaction in the government department, government ministries, government organization, right, should go through this financial regulations, right? The Ministry of Finance is laid down the broad framework. within which departmental financial transaction of all kinds may be undertaken. So in this is how the Ministry of Finance control all of the government institutes, right? So as I told you earlier, the public fund, management of public fund, is all responsibility of the parliament. The parliament has give that duty to the Ministry of Finance, right? So Ministry of Finance is responsible to management of all financial management of the all government organization in Sri Lanka, right? Now from the parliament, Ministry of Finance has taken the work, the duty, right? And FR 124 subsection 2, Minister of Finance is to appoint secretary to a ministry to be the chief accounting officer of his ministry and delegate to him as a chief financial officer the responsibility for the supervising departmental financial transactions subject to direction of the treasury. Right, you know the organizational structure of the government of Sri Lanka. The parliament is the ultimate body, is the top management of all public organization in Sri Lanka, right? It's like what we call in board of directors, right? In public company, they say private company, corporation, the parliament is equal what board of directors. Public sector account for public sector organization, the board of directors who. But actually, for your understanding purpose, I'm saying like this, right? The board of directors, the parliament has given the authority to the Ministry of Finance. In corporations, private corporations, they have given this to chairman, and chairman will appoint the chief financial officer. Likewise, the chief financial officer first we understand the organizational structure of the government organization, right? The parliament, under the parliament there are ministries. So each minister is responsible, head, right? And each ministry having a secretary to the ministry, right? Each ministry has secretary to the ministry. Under the ministry, there are several departments. So for example, under the parliament, Ministry of Education, right? Under the Ministry of Education, there are many departments. Say Ministry of Education, and so here, the Department of Examination, right? And school administration and universities, UGC, is coming under the Ministry of Finance. Under the ministry, there are different departments. So Ministry of Finance is to appoint. So Minister of Finance is to appoint secretary to the ministry to be the chief accounting officer of his ministry and delegates to him the responsibility for supervising departmental financial transactions subject to the direction of the treasury. Right? So we know that each ministry is having a secretary to that ministry. Each ministry has having secretary to the ministry. The overall responsibility of financial management is lay in the hand of Minister of Finance. Right? So therefore, to supervise all the financial transactions of each ministry, the Ministry of Finance will appoint the secretary to each ministry as a chief accounting officer, like CFO, right? Chief accounting officer. In summary, every secretary to the ministry should work as a chief accounting officer for his ministry, right? Accounting officer and the revenue accounting officer. You know that under each ministry, there are several departments. So for each department, the minister will appoint a head for each department. So accounting officer, who is accounting officer and revenue officer is explained in financial regulation number 125. It says, except where other arrangements are made by the treasury, head of each department, so departments are running under each ministry. Under the each ministry, there are several departments. So each department is having each head. Right? For each department, every department having one head. So the head of the each department will be the accounting officer. Right? Head of the each department will be the accounting officer. The secretary to the ministry is a chief accounting officer, right? The secretary of the ministry should work as a chief accounting officer, but for the head of the department work as an accounting officer, right? Don't confuse. There are two positions, chief accounting officer and accounting officer. The head of each department will be the accounting officer in respect of all financial transactions of his department. As such, he is immediately responsible to his chief accounting officer in the manner laid down in the financial regulation. Right? The chief accounting officer is responsible to secretary to the Ministry of Finance. Each chief accounting officer, it's mean secretary of the ministry, is responsible to Ministry of Finance in terms of financial transactions. Likewise, each head of the departments is as a accounting officer is responsible to secretary to the ministry, as the secretary is the chief accounting officer, right? And in addition to the accounting officer, FR 125 part B, it says a revenue officer in addition to accounting officer, they assign a revenue officer. Each secretary to the ministry, right? So I will discuss later. So each secretary of the ministry shall, in addition to his being chief accounting officer of his ministry and the department under the ministry, be the accounting officer for the department of ministry office. So we know in the organizational structure of Sri Lanka, right? So we have ministry, right? That's one office, one premises for ministry office. For department office in other places, right? Say Ministry of Education earlier, the head, the department handling school education, right? It is situated in Isurupaya, right? Department of Examination is situated in Isurupaya, right? But Ministry of Education is situated in what place? Colombo. The Minister Secretary, mainly the Secretary of the Ministry is work as a chief accounting officer for his ministry. But at the same time, the secretary is responsible for all the transactions at the ministry office. So therefore, in that circumstance, the secretary should work chief accounting officer as well as accounting officer on his ministry office. On the ministry office, here each secretary to the ministry shall, in addition to his being an accounting officer of his ministry and the departments under the ministry, be the accounting officer for the department of ministry office. So it's mean the ministry office is assumed as a department for the accounting purpose. For that department, the secretary is the head of the ministry office, and therefore he should work as the accounting officer. It's mean on his office he has taken two role. The first one, chief accounting officer, and for his office he is taking an accounting officer, right? And in addition to the accounting officer, they are appointing revenue officer, revenue accounting officer. It's laid down in FR 125 subsection 2, revenue accounting officer. It is different from accounting officer, revenue officer, revenue accounting officer. The treasury will indicate from time to time the officers who will be responsible for the preparation of estimate of revenue, especially for the revenue under the different heads, subheads, items and sub items, and who will ultimately be accountable for variations between estimates and actual collections, right? So there are some department, they are collecting revenues on behalf of the government. So for example, the Department of Inland Revenue, right, is the major department who is generating revenue for the government, right? Likewise, the government having two things, the main expenditure as well as revenue. For the revenue purpose, the treasury will indicate from time to time the officer who will be responsible, which officer is responsible for the preparation of estimates. They have to prepare budget for revenues under the different heads, subheads, items and sub items, and who will ultimately be accountable for the variations between the estimates and actual collections. Such officer shall, for the purpose of this regulation, be referred as the revenue accounting officer, right? And the function of accounting officer and revenue accounting officers are indicated in FR 128. Please refer financial regulation 128, right? It is already uploaded in your BLE. And FR 126, treasury supervision and control. How treasury mean what? The office of the Minister of Finance. Treasury, this means what? One of the office of Minister of Finance, treasury. So they are the ultimate supervisor in the financial aspects of the government. The chief function of the treasury is to maintain control and supervision of the government finance, right? The main function of the treasury is to maintain control and supervision, control as well as supervision of the government finance. So it is therefore the duty of the treasury to set up a system. So they have to set up a system of financial administration that is satisfactory in all respects, especially with regard to accounting, security and responsibility, right? So the treasury's duty is to supervise all the financial transactions in the government sector. So therefore they have to take all the steps regarding the accounting, security and responsibility of the financial management of the government sector. So this it does in the two ways. How treasury manage all the financial transaction of the government, right? In two ways, right? How treasury manage the finance of the government. First, by regulations, directives and instructions that are generally accepted, that generally applicable, right? So we know that all the government officers should work with regulations, circulars of the government issued by the government. Likewise, accountant, public accountant also, public accountant, government accountant, he is one of the government officers. He also should work with financial regulations, right? Circulars of the government, especially in the financial management aspect, the treasury will issue circulars time to time, right? So in the way of regulations, directives and instruction that are generally applicable, it is common for all institution, all government institution in Sri Lanka, that is generally applicable. The second one, the instructing, by instructing or advising chief accounting officer. Who is chief accounting officer? Who is chief accounting officer? Please respond. So I am taking more times to explain these things because without knowing this basic concept, you are unable to understand what is the structure of financial management. So who is chief accounting officer? Who is chief accounting officer? Secretary to the ministry. Very good. Very good. And who is accounting officer? Who is accounting officer? Chief accounting officer is differ from accounting officer. Chief accounting officer is secretary to the ministry. And who is accounting officer? Yes, head of the departments. Head of the departments. Very good. Right. By instructing or advising chief accounting officer and accounting officer of any special measures necessary in particular circumstances. Here, the time to time, Ministry of Finance will instruct chief accounting officer, it's mean ministry secretary and the head of the departments. It is not common for all, right? So here, the part A is common for all. Say, for example, financial regulation, FR, issued in 1992. It is common for all government organizations operating in Sri Lanka. But time to time, the Minister of Finance will issue circulars. Say, for example, salary increment, right? Salary increment and some allowances, right? That is especially for that particular department, not for all government servant, right? How the Ministry of Finance controlling and supervising of government organizations. Here in this slide, the controlling and supervisory function of the treasury include the following. It is laid down, it's clearly laid down by the financial regulation of FR number 126. So this FR clearly explain how treasury control and supervise all the organization in financial aspects. First, to provide the appointment, the treasury will provide appointment as chief accounting officer and an accounting officer to determine the duties and responsibilities, right? The secretary to the ministry is appointed by the president of Sri Lanka, right? The secretary to the ministry is appointed by president of Sri Lanka, but at the same time, the Ministry of Finance, especially treasury, will appoint him as a chief accounting officer. Chief accounting officer, and each head of the department as appointed as accounting officer. At the time of the appointment, they clearly determine what are the duties and responsibilities of them. in respect of financial transactions. That's number one. Number two, to communicate and interpret all financial directions of the Minister of Finance to all chief accounting officers and accounting officer. So time to time, government, you know, Minister of Finance will issue the circulars. So the interpretation, so who will send circulars on behalf of the government and the chief behalf of the government and the ministry? Treasury will communicate and interpret if the public accountant having any troubles and any misinterpretations, they have to get clarification from Treasury, right? They will communicate, they will direct. That's number two. Number three, to maintain control over the department, departmental cadres, scale of salaries, rate of wages, etc. Right. So, for example, you want a new cadre, right? You have to fill a vacant, and you are demanding for salary increment, or you want another new salary scale. Right. So in previous years, many government department organizations protest against previous government for they are demanding higher salaries. They're demanding different scales of their salaries. So who will finally decide? Not by the department, not by the ministry. All the things, all the cadre, vacant, scale of salaries, salary scale and wage, finally is decided by the Treasury. Without the approval of the Treasury, even minister of such particular minister can't do anything, right? That is number three, the way of controlling the finance. Number four, satisfy itself that revenues and other monies due to the government, including those to commercial activities and deposits, are promptly collected and brought to account by government departments. Right, in case of collection of revenue which belongs to the government of Sri Lanka, it should satisfy themselves all the collected money, collected dues are deposited to the bank account, to government account. Right, the accounting officer should confirm, right, the certify to the secretary, to the ministry and treasury, all the revenues has been properly collected and deposited to the government fund. That is number four. Then to satisfy itself that financial regulations are complied with government departments, and also the accounting officers and chief accounting officers should ensure that they are completely in line with financial regulations. They are following financial regulations. If the account, public accountant, government accountants violates the financial regulations, it is a serious offense. It's a serious offense, right? That is number five. And to exercise supervision over the consolidated fund. Consolidated fund, I have already explained what is consolidated fund. So it's a common fund, right? All the revenues belongs to the consolidated fund. For any expenditures, government expenditures, the money will be taken from the consolidated fund by the way of warrants issued by the Ministry of Finance, Treasury especially. To exercise supervision over the consolidated fund and other government fund accounts, as well as over the monies held in deposits, right? All the monies are deposited in consolidated fund. And FR 127, it says general responsibilities of chief accounting officer. Responsibility of chief accounting officer. A chief accounting officer is responsible to Ministry of Finance. Chief accounting officer means the secretary of each ministry is responsible to Minister of Finance for adequacy of the financial administration of the all departments right? The chief accounting officer is responsible to Ministry of Finance. At the same time, he is responsible to all the financial administration of the all departments under his ministry. Under his ministry, as a chief accounting officer, his duties are mainly supervise. Right, as a chief accounting officer, he supervises all the department, all the departments. Right, he should ensure all departments are in line with financial regulations and the circulars of the Ministry of Finance. And it is also a duty of the chief accounting officer to appear before the Committee on Public Accounts and to assist it along with accounting officer in explaining and justifying the accounts of the department for which is responsible, right? For he should appear on Committee of Public Accounts on behalf of his ministry, and also he should assist the head of the departments, as the head of the departments are the accounting officers, no? Right? So he is the person responsible to explaining and justifying any issues arises in the departments. And 128 explains the duties of accounting officer. 127 is explain the responsibility of chief accounting officer, but 128 explains the responsibility of accounting officer, especially head of the departments. An accounting officer is responsible to chief accounting officer for the financial administration of his department and the management of his wards, right? And subsection of 128 2, duties and responsibilities of revenue accounting officer. So a revenue accounting officer is responsible to the chief accounting officer. Who is that chief accounting officer? He is the ministry secretary, to take adequate steps to collect revenue, right? And right, the executive function of the treasury as a department. So the treasury is a ministry of finance, no, itself is a department under the Ministry of Finance. In addition to its duties under 126, the treasury carries out the normal executive function of a department of the Ministry of Finance. The treasury is a department, one of the departments of the under the Ministry of Finance. The secretary to the treasury, in his capacity as secretary to the Ministry of Finance, is also chief accounting officer, right? Very simple. The office of the Ministry of Finance is treasury. We name as treasury, right? The deputy secretary of the treasury is the accounting officer of the wards directly administered by the treasury, right? Right, delegation of functions of financial control. And now time is 11 o'clock. Right,